All right, moving on from that, the auto industry has come out and posted some very impressive numbers in the previous month of the year. Ketan Thakkar has been examining those reports, and here's what we found out.
India's Motown continues to ride on the good times. Despite the festive season out of the way, there seems to be the latent unsatiated demand for cars and bikes in the country. Maruti Suzuki's sales zoomed 66.6% with more demand for small cars and Swift Dzire. While Mahindra & Mahindra continues to ride on the success of its UVs Xylo and Bolero by posting nearly 100% growth. Good response to the newly launched Manza and increased delivery of Nano spiked Tata Motors passenger car sales by 48%. The numbers look spectacular, primarily due to the low base effect of last year. But still the momentum has carried on and exports are picking up too.
You can see spending is back. So I think the external environment is very good, but also the internal strategy has to be right as well. And I think for us, luckily the internal strategy is bang on.
Hero Honda continues to break personal records with a 31.8% growth, whereas Chennai-based TVS Motor saw a growth of 22.8%. Even the truck makers have joined the party. Thanks to increased industrial productivity, Tata Motors CV sales grew by 81%, with medium and heavy commercial vehicle sales growing by 116%. But are there any shocks to break this rally?
Yes, the commodity prices have been firming up. We've seen the trend in the full first half of this year. We're also seeing upward movement in this quarter. Indeed, if the price rise is any sharper than what we're seeing now, we will look at our pricing once again.
Growing sales may be a good news, but the price hike and possible fears of government's withdrawal of stimulus packages and hardening of interest rate may put the brakes on this joyride. In Mumbai, Ketan Thakkar, NDTV Profit.
Tubar.com.